All right, today we're going to take a look at the removal of the complete secondary air injection system, or SAI as it's called. We're removing this from a 2003 Audi TT with a BEA engine code, and it is a USA version, so it could be a little bit different than the European versions, and some engine codes could be a little bit different also. So this is the whole system, basically. This is what we remove. So it's quite a weight savings, and it's whether you need it on the car or not, who knows, but a lot of guys tend to want to remove it. So what it does basically is it injects ambient air basically into the exhaust system on a cold start to help with the emissions and get the whole exhaust system ready to fire. This is required sometimes in some of your inspections, since it is an emissions. So you want to make sure you check that it is not required for your inspection systems. I have a classic plate on my 2003 Audi, so I don't have emissions checks, so I can go ahead and remove it. So you will encounter some check engine codes related with the system. Some we're going to defeat with a resistor, and all of them can be defeated with Maestro tuning software or Uridyne. Typically, the codes will not affect the drivability of the vehicle. They'll be sort of a nuisance code. So we're going to be removing the N112 valve. We're going to be removing the SAI, this large pump motor right here, and the smaller combi valve, and then also all the basic tubing and hoses, basically one that goes to the airbox, one that goes back to the combi valve, and then the combi valve is mounted really directly right on the engine itself. So what you're going to need for the N112 is you're going to need a resistor to eliminate the code for that. So you can use like a 330 ohm, 1 or 2 watt resistor, or you can go with a store-bought setup, which would sort of look like this right here. You can get those off of eBay or some of your other stores online. We're going to remove, like I said, the SAI pump motor and all the heavy hoses. And once you remove the combination valve or the combi valve, you're going to need this blanking plug to cover up the hole that we leave once we remove that. So here is a look. This is a stock airbox here, and this is normally where one of the SAE hoses connects right here. It's been blocked off on this setup. So this is a little bit different than maybe what yours is going to look like. But one of those hoses will be connected right at the stock airbox. So what we're going to do is you want to remove your stock airbox, probably remove this cover plate so that we can get to the combi valve. We're going to work on the combi valve first. So here we have the airbox removed and our cover plate for the engine. And the combi valve is located down in this area right here. It's a little bit tight to get to. There are a lot of different hoses and crap going on down in there. Yours might look a little bit different, but that's the area we're going to look at. We're going to remove that combi valve first. So let's take a look at a closer look. Here is a closer look at the combi valve. This is one of your large hoses that goes back down to the actual pump itself. So that's been disconnected already. You can see the combi valve is basically right next to your green temp sensor right here. You can see the temp sensor here that senses your antifreeze in your water for coolant. All right, so once we get into this part here, what we want to do, there are two bolts, basically hex bolts, holding this combi valve, holding the combi valve onto a mounting bracket that mounts onto the engine itself. So what I did was I removed the two mounting screws for the combi valve, one here and then one on the other side. Here you can see now those two here, these were the two, this is where the combi valve, here's the combi valve now off. Here is the mounting bracket right here and right here. Okay, a little blown up here. Here's the two that you want to remove so you can remove the combi valve. And then this is the whole mounting bracket that mounts onto the engine itself. And you can see there are three hex head bolts that are going to mount this mounting bracket to the engine itself. So here are the three bolt holes right here. This now we have the mounting bracket and the combi valve removed. And obviously you've got a big hole here in your engine, so that's where we're going to use that blanking plate. So here we have the blanking plate with two more hex bolts that you can buy. You can buy this typically online, eBay, or some of the tuning stores, things like that. So what I did was I rubbed a little bit of oil on the O-ring just to soften the O-ring up, keep it nice and soft, make a good seal, and then use your two hex bolts to bolt it to the side of the motor. And then that part is done. So you've got the combi valve out and you've got our hole all closed up. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to go to our N112, which is right here. And we're going to disconnect the hoses here. This comes from the intake manifold, which you're going to need to cap off that line right there. Just cap it off at the manifold, or you can plug it right. You know, if you disconnect this hose here, you can just plug up that hose right there. This is the line that goes to the combi valve right here. And that is just going to come out with the combi valve. So that whole hose will be deleted and removed along with the N112 valve here. So here's a more of a stock look at the N112 valve. It's on this large plate that's actually bolted to the underside of the intake manifold. So here are your hoses coming out. All right, this is the one, I think, to the combi valve here. This is the one that you're going to blank off and close off. All right, so here's the N112 valve removed on my setup, and I just put a homemade resistor and taped it off and put it in temporarily until I could get, you know, a store-bought. And I think I used about a 330 ohm resistor. That's pretty typical for a lot of these valves. And like a 1 or 2 watt resistor is fine. Where, you know, when you're talking about 330 ohms of resistance and only 12 volts from our battery system, it's really not drawing a lot of current. So there's not a whole lot of power to dissipate. So you don't need like a 10 watt or a 20 watt resistor. So I know some guys do that, but a 1 or 2 watt resistor is fine. So here are some of our resistor, sort of blanking resistor setups that you can buy offline. They come with a plug that plugs right in there, and then they just have a resistor inside that. Again, you can buy those at eBay stores. All right, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to remove the injection pump. That's a pretty big unit underneath on the front of the engine there. You can see here's your oil filter. So it's just below the oil filter here. So we're going to go ahead and remove this whole contraption. First off, what you've got to do, of course, to get to this, you got to remove your belly pan. There are two side panel partial plastic plates that look like this on the driver's side and the passenger side. I think I just removed the passenger side and loosely removed or partially removed the driver's side. You almost have to remove those just to get the front crossover pipe out. You will have to remove the front crossover pipe. That's the pipe that basically connects your side mount intercoolers. If you have a front mount intercooler, it's probably not connected to anything. And some guys actually remove it, but some guys keep it just because they think it's a little bit extra stability for the front. All right, so what we're going to do first off is remove the connector. Right here is the connector on our big pump. We're going to remove that connector and get it out of the way. Then we're going to go ahead and remove the two large hoses right here. They're just sort of like flexible hoses. One went up to the combi valve and one went up to the air intake. So those we can go ahead and remove those and get those out of your way, so it makes it a little bit easier to remove the pump itself. So here is the pump, and here is the mounting. This is a mounting bracket right here. And what we're going to do is we're going to remove the three mounting nuts right here. There's one back in here that you can barely see, and then one here, one here. Here you can see them here. All right, we're going to remove those, and that will at least make the pump loose so we can move the pump around a little bit. So here are your bolt or your nuts again. So then what we want to do is remove the two bolts for the mounting bracket. All right, and these are really, really difficult to get to. This one up here is very difficult to get to. So there's really not enough room to get the pump out and push this out because the power steering pump is in the way. So actually what I did, you can see here, what I did was I actually cut that bracket and then bent that bracket up, and then I could pull the pump out. And then once the pump is out, let's go back here. Once the pump is out of your way, then you can get the other mounting a nut out, or the another bolt up top. This is really hard. This is up quite a ways up the front of the engine, and it's harder to get. But once you have the pump out, it's a little bit easier to get to. All right, here are your two hoses. Now this is with the pump out and the mounting bracket out. Here is actually the mounting bracket that's still there, but that gets removed. And then here are your two large hoses. So you can remove the two hard hoses, one that went to the air filter and one that went to the combi valve. All right, so here is everything out now. You can see here is the mounting bracket that I did cut. I cut it at two of the bolt holes to make it easier, and then you can actually bend this out of your way and then pull that pull the pump out itself. Here are your large hoses, your combi valve, all the hardware and the mounting bracket and so on and so forth. So that's the removal of the SAI. If you have any questions, certainly go ahead and post it below. And I hope that helps you out. It's a pretty easy removal thing, something that everybody seems to do every now and then once you've had the car a while, and you can go ahead and remove it. But remember, it might be required for your emissions. So don't remove it if it's required for your emissions, or you're going to be in trouble. All right. Hope that helps. Enjoy, guys.